Hey guys, welcome back for another video. Let's talk about understanding the point of the rehearsals and why some rehearsals look so weird or so exaggerated or so not right, okay? So when we do rehearsals, we're doing it at a much slower speed to help you exaggerate the movement, to exaggerate the sensation, to exaggerate the awareness of where certain body parts or the club or the shaft should be. If we exaggerate those things, now we have a chance actually implementing that change even a couple percent of the actual exaggeration. For example, if you're a chronic slicer, if this is your swing, and you've been doing that all your golfing life, chances are if you want to be inside out, you just feeling like you do this to be coming from the inside slightly is probably not gonna net you any change. You're probably still gonna do the same thing, which is why if you want to really make lasting changes, you have to exaggerate the hell out of it, okay? You may think, oh, I'm gonna be stuck, the club is too far back. Well, if you're all the way back there, chances are you'll probably be somewhere in the middle in the real swing, okay? Just because when I show you the video, I'm doing all this exaggeration, you're probably not gonna be even close to the amount I'm doing because I'm doing my best to exaggerate the most I can to help you guys get a better visual in your head, okay? If you're trying to make changes, you have to exaggerate the hell out of it, okay? For example, let's take someone who is a tilter, okay? You tilt back in the downswing, you slide, you don't rotate, you step into your lead foot too early. You just have to do the opposite to the most extreme side of the other side of the spectrum, okay? If you're someone who slides, tilts back, this is impact, you're probably gonna have to feel the opposite of staying on your trail foot and you rotate with no tilting, no sliding. The easiest way to change the fastest is to literally go to the opposite side of the spectrum with the biggest exaggeration possible at slow speeds. Check yourself on camera and see if it changes the picture. If it doesn't change the picture, exaggerate even more. If you see that it has changed the picture, but too much, more often than not, it's not gonna be too much. But just for example, you do a huge, huge exaggeration and it actually changes the picture too much, then at least you know you can dial it back, you try again, lessening the exaggeration, and you check yourself in video again. It really is that simple, okay? I know changing the golf swing is hard, I know golf is hard, but if you truly wanna change the movement, if you wanna truly change the picture, change the result, you just have to exaggerate, you have to be diligent in filming yourself, you have to be disciplined, but it is definitely possible, it can be done, it's hard work, but it's very, very worth it. You're gonna play golf probably for the rest of your life. What is a year or two or 3 years of hard work in the grand scheme of things, okay? Some people may not have that big of an issue, they may make changes in half a year. Other people may take changes in 3 years. At the end of the day, as a process, you keep improving year one, year two, year three, things are gonna get better. Sure, not the entire picture will get better, but certain parts of the picture will get better as you keep progressing on, as you keep progressing onwards and onwards and onwards, as the entire picture starts getting more polished. So don't be afraid to exaggerate. This is why sometimes you see people look super funky with their rehearsals. They may look like this in the rehearsal. They may look like this in the rehearsal. Things that don't look right in the actual golf swing, but look very, very right when done at full speeds. So don't be afraid to exaggerate because, again, at partial speeds, we need to be able to feel the awareness of where the body is. At full speed, things will look different as the forces push your body part and the club into a different position. As in the full speed, you have less time to place, to manipulate things, to consciously move things into a certain direction. So hope that makes sense. Any questions, leave in the comments below. Do not be afraid to exaggerate. Do not be afraid to make a very funny feeling, weird feeling, crappy feeling rehearsal, because more often than not, that's gonna help you more than hurt. So hope that makes sense. Any questions, leave in the comments below and we'll catch you guys next time. Thanks guys.